In this video, we will talk about the different effects of dopamine at different doses and what you should keep in mind when using dopamine for heart failure. Let's get started. Dopamine acts on multiple receptors. These receptors include dopamine receptors, D1 and D2, and adrenergic receptors, beta-1 and alpha-1. Now, the sensitivity of these receptors to dopamine is different. The dopamine receptors are the most sensitive. This means they are stimulated even at a lower concentration of dopamine. The beta-1 receptors are moderately sensitive. So they are stimulated at relatively high concentrations. And alpha-1 receptors are the least sensitive. And they require higher concentration to get stimulated by dopamine. Because of this, dopamine produces a different effect at different doses. The D1 receptors are seen on renal blood vessels, proximal tubular cells, and the heart. Even a low dose of dopamine stimulates these receptors. When stimulated, the receptors in renal blood vessels cause vasodilatation of renal vessels. This increases the glomerular filtration rate. The receptors in proximal tubular cells decrease sodium reabsorption. So sodium excretion is increased, which is called natriuresis. The receptors in the heart produce a positive ionotropic effect. Beta-1 receptors are found in the heart. They are stimulated at moderate doses of dopamine and contribute to the positive ionotropic effect. Alpha-1 receptors are found in blood vessels. They are stimulated at higher doses and cause vasoconstriction. So these are different dose-dependent actions of dopamine. Now, dopamine is commonly used for heart failure. In this condition, renal vasodilatation, natriuresis, and positive inotropic effects are beneficial. Renal vasodilatation helps maintain renal perfusion. The natriuretic effect reduces blood volume, which in turn decreases preload on the heart. The positive ionotropic effect helps the failing heart maintain a force of contraction. But the vasoconstriction is not desired. The vasoconstriction increases peripheral resistance. This increases afterload on the heart and makes it difficult for the failing heart to pump the blood. Because of these things, the dopamine should be given only in low to moderate doses in case of heart failure, but not in a large dose, so that we get only desired effects and not the harmful effects. This was all about dose-dependent actions of dopamine and a caution needed in heart failure patients. Quick summary. D1 receptors are stimulated at a low dose and contribute to the natriuretic effect. Beta-1 receptors are stimulated at moderate doses and produce a positive ionotropic effect. The alpha-1 receptors are stimulated at higher doses and produce vasoconstriction. In patients with heart failure, we want only natriuretic and positive ionotropic effects, but not the vasoconstriction. So dopamine is given in low to moderate doses. Large doses should be avoided. That's it for this video. You can find notes on this topic and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you find our content useful, hit like, comment, and share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.